Since the dawn of humanity, we have looked up at the night sky in awe, dreaming of exploring the stars. In 1961, the first human accomplished that dream when Soviet cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin traveled into outer space. Just 8 years later, our species landed on the moon. Now, over 50 years later, we stand ever closer to the ability for each of us to follow in their footsteps and leave the planet ourselves, if only for a brief visit. When will that ability become a reality? And how might that change the nature of our civilization? Let's take a look and first find how we've come so far already. Humanity's ability to reach outer space began with its aspirations. In the West, the ancient Greeks and Romans told stories of gods and heroes who journeyed to other worlds. In the East, the Hindu epic poem The Ramayana describes a flying machine called the Pushpaka Vimana that could travel between Earth and the heavens. Early ideas for how we might make it there were often fanciful, to say the least. In 1638, English Bishop Francis Godwin published a book in which a man travels to the moon in a flying machine powered by a flock of trained swans. In 1865, Jules Verne wrote a novel that used a cannon to fire its characters there. The groundbreaking 1902 silent film A Trip to the Moon used a cannon as well. But a few got it closer to right. Scientist William Leitch suggested in 1861 that rockets could be used for spaceflight. Sadly, war has historically been the primary driver of advanced rockets. The US military funded much of the work of rocketry pioneer Robert Goddard, who developed the first liquid-fueled rockets. Goddard accused the Nazis of stealing his work to develop their V-2 missile, the first human-made object to reach outer space. Demonstrating military supremacy was also one of the leading motives of the space race between the Soviet Union and the United States. The Soviets were the first to launch a satellite into orbit with Sputnik 1, the first to launch a living animal into space with the dog Laika, who unfortunately did not make it home, and the first to have a human depart and safely return. The United States, however, was the first to fulfill the vision so many science fiction authors had written about. In 1969, Neil Armstrong and Edwin Buzz Aldrin were the first men to land on the moon. However, in the years following this monumental event, the high cost of the space program and the end of the Cold War led the development of spacecraft to increasingly become the domain of the private sector. First came the expansion of public-private partnerships with companies like Boeing and Lockheed Martin, both of whom had worked on the Apollo program. But as the cost of spaceflight continued to rise, new competition interested in developing cheaper and more efficient spacecraft entered the market. Blue Origin, founded by Jeff Bezos in 2000, and SpaceX, founded by Elon Musk in 2002, both focus on developing lower-cost, reusable rockets for both governmental and commercial purposes. However, these companies will not be the first to take private citizens into space. In 1990, the Japanese journalist Toyohiro Akiyama became the first paying space tourist when he was sent to the Soviet space station Mir as part of a commercial agreement between the Tokyo Broadcasting System and the Soviet Union. Akiyama paid a reported $10 to $14 million for the privilege of spending a week in space. The company Space Adventures was founded in 1998 with the mission of sending tourists into space. In 2001, Space Adventures sent its first tourist, American businessman Denis Tito, to the International Space Station aboard a Russian Soyuz spacecraft. Tito paid $20 million for the trip, which lasted about a week. Axiom Space, founded in 2016, flew the first fully privately crewed spacecraft to the International Space Station and aims to own and operate the first privately owned space station. Company Orbital Assembly aims to construct the very first private space hotel, planning to begin construction in 2026. Both Space Adventures and Axiom Space are customers of SpaceX, using their Crew Dragon spacecraft for their flights, and SpaceX runs its own space tourism missions too. Their first mission was Inspiration 4, in which a four-person civilian crew spent 3 days in orbit. SpaceX's Dear Moon project aims to take a crew of 10 on a 6-day trip around the moon. While Axiom Space and SpaceX's flights into orbit cost tens of millions of dollars, suborbital flights, which don't fly passengers quite as far away from our planet, are substantially cheaper. Space Perspective is developing a novel hydrogen balloon-style craft that will take passengers on a 6-hour flight to the lowest edge of space, 32 kilometers above Earth, for only $125,000. Blue Origin is charging approximately $300,000 for just 12 minutes at a 100 kilometers height. And Virgin Galactic, founded in 2004, is charging $450,000 for a reservation aboard their long-delayed Spaceship Two for a 2-hour flight at 80 kilometers. Those prices are still well out of reach for the vast majority of Earthlings, but for those yearning for the chance to like and subscribe to Beyond Now's videos from the stars, it may well become possible within your lifetime. While it's difficult to predict the exact timeline for when space tourism will become more affordable and common, there are a few developments that could potentially drive down the cost and make it more accessible in the future. SpaceX and Blue Origin have already made major innovations in the development of reusable spacecraft and rockets. Scaling up this technology could in the future make it more feasible to launch multiple flights per day, lowering the overall cost per passenger. SpaceX is already in the early stages of designing a rocket that could use low-orbit space travel for the purposes of everyday travel across the planet, with a flight from New York City to Shanghai taking only 39 minutes. Further cost reductions could come by developing more lightweight and durable materials for spacecraft, reducing the cost of manufacturing. Artificial intelligence development could also help by improving spacecraft design and performance. AI algorithms could optimize rocket propulsion systems and spacecraft trajectories, leading to reduced fuel consumption and lower launch costs. Back here on Earth, an AI-powered economic boom could make prices that once seemed out of reach available to more and more people. Just as so many of the items in your home were too costly for most people mere decades ago. If we can achieve it, affordable space tourism could bring people from different countries and cultures together, creating a shared experience that fosters a greater sense of global community. And building more industry in space could pave the way for future space exploration, and maybe even one day colonization efforts on Mars and other planets. Space travel is a testament to human ingenuity, curiosity, and determination. The future of space travel is a bright and exciting one. But just as it was for the millennia of thinkers who paved the way for the Apollo 11 mission, it's up to us here on Earth today to make our dreams for the next frontier a reality. Do you want to travel to space? Do you think it would be possible for you within your lifetime? And what do you dream of doing out there? Join the conversation and predict the future with us down in the comments. Beyond Now is a new channel dedicated to helping people connect with humanity and the universe's past, and to inspire them to dream about the future. We have big plans to create much more content doing just that. In addition to liking, commenting, and subscribing, we hope you'll also consider supporting Beyond Now to enable us to continue making videos and grow our channel by becoming a patron. Our Patreon offers a community to think big with other supporters and to get early access to Beyond Now videos and bonus content. No matter how you choose to support us, we truly appreciate it. We rely on viewer support, and your help enables us to achieve our goal of spreading human connection and inspiration. Thank you so much for watching and supporting Beyond Now.